old minister, he announces off allocation, he might just go out and ring bark some more trees, you know, like. Apparently 40s was a drought period, but if you have a look at how much water come down the river in the 40s compared to what comes down now, there's a hell of a lot more. Ever since we first come to the marshes, grandfather came about 1880, I think, up to near Butterbone, and there's none of us have ever left the area. So I don't know what the future generations want to do, but well, you would think they would have a liking to have a life, but the way it is now, it wouldn't support many people, like the marshes doesn't support many people. About 1989, I was here mustering the cattle, and there was a bit of a fair-sized flood coming through. I was mustering on the other side of the channel, taking the cattle that way on a horse, and I had a chap, Wally, my friend, he's from Sydney, and he's on this side of the channel, and he got a bit slewed, and he was taking the cattle that way on this side of the channel, and we're only about 70 metres apart, and the cattle are walking in water, and they're making a lot of noise and bellowing and that. We couldn't see each other because the kabungi and reeds were that high in that channel that we could, on horseback, we could not see across it. Well, this is used to be water cooch. It's like Gilgai water cooch country. Oh, one beast a cow and calf at 10 acres sort of was a environmentally friendly sort of stocking rate for it. And now it's roly-poly. But you can see across here that there's roly-poly as high as you can get. And but there's nothing underneath it. If you rake the roly-poly off, you get the get other stuff to grow, and it's only pigweed and roly-poly again coming up, but at least it's fresh. Used to be reeds, couch grass, and some of it was just open water just there because that was pretty deep. Well, previously when floods came, it had been a big lot of couch grass here to stop the tree coming up as well, and what did survive would be cut out by the next rise of water. Those trees would have come up after the 2000 flood. You can see all the, like the big trees, there's a big tree coming up here now. He's up on the higher knobs where the little ones are in the lower gully things. They put the dam in 65, so it's all development. That's what their mentality was, and rightly so, like everyone wants to develop things. And they over-allocated this river, and I think they've over-allocated a lot of rivers, but on this river it's just far greatly, grossly over-allocated. We done a bit of a survey in 96 of the areas when Burrendong was completed, and on the western area there's about 10% of the houses were abandoned by 96, and on the eastern side of the river there's about 15% of the houses. And in the marsh area then it had 60% of the houses abandoned by 96. So that's sort of, and that's, you know, some of them only had half their place would have been flooded, and that, but they just cut their carrying capacity down to Villiers.